गोवन वार्ता लाइव चे यूट्यूब चैनल सब्सक्राइब करा आणि बेल आयकॉन दाबून लेटेस्ट वीडियो चे नोटिफिकेशन मिळवा।
तहलकाचे संस्थापक तरुण टेजपाल यांना त्यांच्या महिला सहकाऱ्याच्या लैंगिक अत्याचार प्रकरणी जिल्हा आणि सत्र न्यायालयाने निर्दोष मुक्त केलं। काही ना काही कारणास्तव पुढे ढकलण्यात आलेला निवाडा अखेर शुक्रवारी जाहीर झाला। दुर्दैवाने या खटल्यात तरुण टेजपाल यांच्या वतीने युक्तिवाद केलेले ॲडव्होकेट राजीव गोम्स यांचे मात्र अलीकडेच कोविडने निधन झालं। ॲडव्होकेट गोम्स यांनी दिलेला कायदेशीर लढा आपण विसरू शकत नाही असं त्यांनी म्हटलंय। या व्यतिरिक्त या कठीण प्रसंगी आपल्याला पाठिंबा दिलेल्या तसंच आधार दिलेल्या सर्वांप्रती त्यांनी कृतज्ञता व्यक्त केली आहे। गोव्यात 7 आणि 8 नोव्हेंबर 2013 साली विचार महोत्सवाचं आयोजन केलं होतं। यावेळी तरुण टेजपाल यांच्याकडून आपला लैंगिक अत्याचार झाल्याची तक्रार त्यांच्याच एका महिला सहकाऱ्यानं केली होती। सगळ्याच राजकीय पक्ष आणि राजकीय नेत्यांच्या स्टिंग ऑपरेशन्समुळे तहलकाचा दबदबा होता। या पार्श्वभूमीवर सदर महिला पत्रकाराच्या तक्रारीची दखल घेऊन तात्काळ कारवाई करण्यात आली आणि 28 नोव्हेंबर 2013 रोजी तेजपाल यांना अटक करण्यात आली। यानंतर तब्बल 4.5 महिने ते कोठडीत राहिले। 19 मे 2013 रोजी त्यांना अंतरिम जामीन मंजूर झाला। गेली 7 वर्ष हा खटला सुरू होता। खरं तर 19 मे रोजी हा निवाडा होणार होता। तौक्ते वादळामुळे वीज पुरवठा खंडित झाल्यामुळे तो पुढे ढकलून शुक्रवारी 21 रोजी जाहीर करण्याचं ठरलं। सर्वोच्च न्यायालयाच्या निर्देशानुसार येथील अतिरिक्त जिल्हा व सत्र न्यायालयात ह्या खटल्याचे युक्तिवाद सुरू होते। न्यायालयाकडून अंतिम निवाडा देण्याची तारीख गेल्या 27 एप्रिल रोजी देण्यात आली होती, पण त्यावेळी न्यायालयाने निवाड्याची सुनावणी तहकूब करून 12 मे रोजी सुनावणी निश्चित केली। बुधवारी 12 रोजी सुनावणी वेळी न्यायालयाने नवीन तारीख देत 19 मे पर्यंत अंतिम निवाडा तहकूब केला आणि त्यानंतर अखेर तो 21 मे रोजी घेण्याचं ठरलं।
Seldom does a long fought for vindication arrive hand in hand with profound heartbreak. Last week, my trial lawyer Rajiv Gomes died of COVID. Dynamic and brilliant, at 47 he was on the brink of a scintillating career as a criminal lawyer at the national level. No person fought harder and with greater skill to reclaim my life and reputation. Rajiv used to say to me, I enjoy money but I don't work for it. I believe God put me on earth to fight for the innocent. As a family, we owe Rajiv Gomes a profound and permanent debt. And we grieve alongside his wife Cheryl and his young son Sean. No client can ever hope for a better lawyer than Rajiv. The ever struggling weed of justice has lost a solid spoke. In November 2013, I was falsely accused of sexual assault by a colleague. Today, the Honorable Trial Court of Additional Sessions Judge Shama Joshi in Goa has honorably acquitted me. In an awfully vitiated age where ordinary courage has become rare, I thank her for standing by the truth. The past 7.5 years have been traumatic for my family as we have dealt with the catastrophic fallout of these false allegations on every aspect of our personal, professional and public lives. We have felt the boot of the state, but through it all, we have cooperated fully with the Goa police and the legal system through hundreds of court proceedings. We have unwaveringly followed every mandate of due procedure and abided by every principle of law as laid down in the Constitution. We have also endeavored to uphold every norm of decency expected in a case like this. It is with profound respect that I thank this court for its rigorous, impartial and fair trial and for its thorough examination of the CCTV footage and other empirical material on record. In these 8 years, a host of outstanding lawyers came to our aid and we owe them all a deep debt. Prime among them, Pramod Dubey, Amir Khan, Ankur Chawla, Amit Desai, Kapil Sibal, Salman Khurshid, Aman Lekhi, Sandeep Kapoor, Ryan Karanjawala and Srikant Shivre. I also thank scores of family members and friends who kept the faith and stood by us through these dark years. I wish to make no further statement at this time and request my family's privacy be respected as we try and reclaim our broken lives. I will make a comprehensive statement at an appropriate time in the future. Tarun Jay
Tejpal. So I'm Sean Gomes. I come here today on behalf of my father, Advocate Rajiv Gomes. I would like to thank the court today for passing such a fair and just judgment, and I would like to congratulate Mr. Tarun Tejpal on his personal victory. I would like to say that my father has put in a tremendous amount of hard work and dedication into this case. The final written argument was consisting of 600 plus pages, which shows the amount of workload that he put in into the case. Also, I would like to say that I'm personally honored to have seen one of India's best lawyers at work, because he's worked really hard. And I would also like to say that it would be wonderful if he was here personally to claim this victory. However, one way or another, history has already been made. And that's all. Any further questioning you can ask me.
Could you please confirm Mr.
Tejpal's
age?
What?
He's coming down here.
He's coming, you can ask him.
He's there on top.
So what about today's
judgment? Today's judgment is actually a great victory for everybody, especially Advocate Rajiv Om, his advocate, and Tarun Tejpal also. And it is basically exclusively because of the hard work and the effort and my advocate senior advocate Rajiv Om. And to the today's honorable session could activate from all the sections like section 341, 342, 376, 376, 2. And 354A, everything from all the equipment.
So detail order has been given.
Detail order has not been given yet because not they will upload on the site CIS. So we'll get it by tomorrow. Not maybe today or tomorrow, but they will upload. But as of now, we have even got a copy in hand. But that's the thing. And unfortunately, my senior advocate Rajiv Om is not there because that's what I was. He's the man behind this victory.
म्हापसा जिल्हा अतिरिक्त सत्र न्यायालयानं दिलेल्या निवाड्याला उच्च न्यायालयात आव्हान दिलं जाईल असं ॲडव्होकेट फ्रान्सिस्को यांनी म्हटलंय.
That's all that I can say at this point. Certainly will have to be, because we still have to get a copy. We have applied. That's what we were doing right now. We were applying for a copy of the judgment. So no sooner we get that, we will be going to the reasons assigned by the judge. And of course, we will be preferring the appeal. There is a certain period within which it has to be filed, and we will be filing within that time frame. That's for sure.
So, do you see it as a setback?
Yes, serious setback. Serious, yeah. That's why we feel seriously aggrieved, and therefore we'll be preferring an appeal against it.